Hello, Axe fans. Cabin in the woods time, right? It was more like, you know, a nice little chateau by a reservoir. A semi-arid, you know, high country plateau. All right, but cabin in the woods. Hey, I really appreciate everybody's watching these videos and making comments and stuff. It's very encouraging. Makes me want to keep doing them. It's cool, right? I'm no expert. I'm no mountain man lumberjack, okay? I'm not here to tell you how to do things. I'm just an axe collector. Got a bunch of axes, you know, and so I want to try them out. See what I can learn. See what you can learn about axe design and axe performance from all these great new and old patterns. So I want to try something different, right? It's a little different this time. I want to do a people's choice group. So we're at group H, which is like a bunch of groups. We're already group H. And so what I want to do is just, it's your choice this time. It's your choice. You just watch it and see, and then you can choose which of these is going to advance on to the final rounds with the elite axes. Elite axes. Yeah, right? Axe science, yo. Feeling very Boy Scouty today up in the woods, right? I got my Boy Scout Jack shirt. Right? Still fits from my time as a scout master, venture crew leader. Any of y'all do any of that? Man, I did that for years. Years and years and years. Teaching little kids how to tie knots. It was awesome. It was really awesome. So we have three really unique axes for this test and kind of an interesting test, okay? It's a little different how we're going to do this. A little more convenient. I'm excited. But should display the capabilities of the axe, no problem, all right? So our first one today. So I have finally modified my Stihl Universal Pro Forestry Axe from an earlier video. For whatever reason, the most watched video on my small and newbie channel is a backyard review I did of this axe. This is Stihl Universal Pro Forestry Axe, all right? It's a really interesting and striking axe here. Marketed as an all-round, all-purpose axe. It's got all this stuff up here. Got an axe collar and a really, really elaborate fastening system on an Oxen cup, 1,250-gram head. So that puts it in at, what, like, you know, 2.75 pounds, somewhere in there. But with all this metal and stuff over there, it's quite heavy. It's on a short, very European-style handle. This is very much how the Euros love it. All right, thick, round, beefy. You know, just give you confidence and strength and durability over time. So this is just an incredibly, I would say, overbuilt axe, right? It's just more in there than a lot of stuff you ever see. And so in the backyard review, it was okay. It was okay. And, you know, the thing I didn't like about it at all, if you watch that review, is that the factory angle is just this beef 45-degree, you know, splitting maul edge, okay? Which, yeah, if you're going to split with this, you know, in the car, okay, that's fine. But if you've watched any of these videos, you know that that is not going to cut. It's just not going to cut it. That's not going to be any kind of good time, no matter what you say, with an angle that, you know, obtuse, right? Obtuse. So what I did is I filed this down to a competitive 22.5 degree, all right? Nice, it's not flat, it's kind of convex in here, but you know, I'm still trying to preserve kind of the wedge effect. So if you wanted to split with it, split with it. But now hopefully it'll cut a lot better than before. And so that'll be fun. Short, beefy guy. And it's time, Axe fans, for the Basque Axe. The Urnieta Acha Artesana, okay? I don't know if you're not familiar with the Basque axe, you could tell this is a very unique axe, right? Apparently the Basques have this amazing and vibrant timber sports culture, kind of axe culture in the Basque country. They have their own competitions, they have these great outfits, they have unique tests, and you know, the trappers are very famous and celebrated and get hams and flowers and sashes. It's really cool, right? And out of all that experience has come a unique design. There's really nothing else like it in these Basque axes, okay? So this is the 2 kilogram version. That's the total weight of the axe. The weight of their axe is a little different. It's not the head weight, it's the total weight of the axe. And this is a beech wood handle, and it's a slip fit head. That's why it's so narrow and shaped like this, and there's a very, very small foot here, palm swell, because it's got to fit all the way through the eye. It's not too hard to take it off. You've got to be careful. This beech is not as hard and sturdy as hickory. Okay, And so I've already made a mistake of kind of chipping off this little end here, just beating on it. That was a bad idea. Glued it back together. It's okay. But this is how it works. See? Got a, like a 25 and a half inch handle here. Very light. All right. On what turns out to be a, for the 2K size, this was 675 grams. Right? So it's pretty heavy head, like 3.8 pounds. Big head. All the weight's up here in the top. Incredible design. This is really, really interesting. All right. It has... straight from the factory, an edge that is totally in the danger zone. Yeah, it's a danger zone edge, about 18 degrees. So, you know, five chorizos to the Basques, you know, for putting that in a production axe. That's an incredibly aggressive, you know, it's a danger zone. Yeah, it's in the danger zone. We've seen some failures and out here with frozen wood. We'll see how it goes. But a very, very interestingly shaped head, has a very high center line. It has these smooth phantom bevels here in the heel and the toe. And this is a long and storied design, right? Where the phantom bevels here on the edges are designed, you know, it's a depression, okay? All the pressure's in the middle. The axe goes in, starts to spread the wood, and these bevels release the pressure on the edge of the chips. You know what I mean? It just releases the pressure so it doesn't stick as much. And the idea, maybe it flies more, you know, you get more penetration and power out of it just as a big wedge. Beautiful sweeping angle, great steel. Great steel, kind of mysterious what they're doing. That's a very aggressive angle, and this just is impervious so far, maybe today. But very convenient, you know, if you're a handle guy, you want to switch your mount. That's one of the things I want to find out, is if the different lengths of handles just fit with all the heads. Just give a little tappy boy here, and it's back in action. So maybe you could switch out handles. I don't know, I haven't tested that, but this will be fun. People's choice. So it's hard to find things that unique, but you know, couldn't get out of Axe Arena without trying out a very old, very attractive, abandoned design, the Finnish collared axe. This is a Belnas, a Finnish company. And this is a design that's kind of been abandoned, all right? For a lot of reasons. One, they're hard as hell to haft. This is a completely counterintuitive hafting mechanism in here, where the top of the eye is this much, bottom of the eye is this much, so it's just the opposite. Well, the Finns thought it was a good idea, right? They have nothing but darkness and endless winters to deal with. Maybe that's just like, well, let's make this as hard as possible. Makes it more beautiful in the end, maybe. I don't know what. But it's a top-heavy axe, right? All the weight's up here, ton of weight in the collar, kind of like the Stihl, right? And so all these are top-heavy axes. And by that, I mean there's a lot of weight up here, short, thin handles, with the exception of Stihl, it's a very thick handle. But still, the weight's all up top. So you just got a lot of momentum in the swing on a shorter head. Can't get stock handles for these anymore. So this was fixed up by a friend. Really nice. Actually has a 25 degree full convex grind there. So it's very narrow, but that's nice and sharp, very evenly sloped. This will be fun. Nothing else but fun, right? Finland. Look what we got here. Landscape trees. Very louche, right? Well, they've outlived their usefulness. They're all up here in the power lines, but the tree guys trimmed them. They look terrible. Time for them to go. All right, it's time for them to go. Nice, you know, 8-inch frozen aspen is what we got, right? So why not? That sounds very Finnish. We're going to have snow coming down on us. Yeah, we are. All right, yuck it up, guys. Yuck it up. Finland.
Early in the morning, before the sun comes up, you toss your lunchbox into your pickup truck. The day starts jumping as you're laying that timber down. Cutting pulpwood and sawlogs and chip and saw, and loading them log trucks out, that's what it's all about. Well, I got a good job, I work hard for my money, when it's hot outside. I keep the wood roll. I fire up my old cat, let that black smoke roll. I keep pulling in them big rags time after time. That's how we all roll out here in the pines. Yeah, load them up, chime down, make a little money before sundown. Yeah, cut them down, skid them out, load them trucks, that's what it's all about. Oh, cut them down, skid them out, load them trucks, day in and out. Weather's been bad and it's getting real muddy. I need to make some quota for the end of the week. The bills keep coming even when that weather's bad. We're gonna head out to the woods today. There just ain't no other way. We all got bills to pay. Yeah, load them up, chime down, make a little money before Sunday. I said, cut them down, skid them out, load the truck, that's what it's all about. And I said, cut them down, skid them out, load the truck, stay in it out. Yeah, let's load them up, chime down, make a little money before sundown. I said, cut them down, skid them out, load the truck, that's what it's all about. Oh, cut them down, skid them out, load the trucks, that's what it's all about. I said, cut them down, skid them out, load the trucks, that's what it's all about. I'll say it again. I said, cut them down, skid them out, load the trucks, day in and out.
Give up my jolly teamsters, it's time to start the rout. The teamsters, they will all jump up in a most frightful way. Where is me boots, where is me pants, me socks is gone astray. And then comes up the logger, all at the break of day. Load up my slide 500 feet to the river, drive away. You can hear those axes ringing until the sun goes down. Hurrah, my boys, the day is spent to the shanty we are bound. When we reach the shanty with cold hands and wet feet, we there pull off our larrikins, a supper for to eat. We sing and dance till 9 o'clock, then to our bunks we climb. Those winter months, they won't be long in hurling down the pond.
We're all right, Axe fans. There you go. There's the data. You know, last night, after the chop, I had this whole shoot. I did a whole shoot of the end here. All right, inside the cabin by the fireside. Yeah, so I thought it'd be great, but it was not. It was not a great shoot. I woke up, I watched the footage, I'm like, oh my God, I gotta put this in. Had gems like this.
I look like a vampire. Like this is a vampire in a castle or something. The terrible lighting. I got a floor light here, like a lamp. Like a table lamp. Trying to shut up.
Oh yeah, that was great.
Vote in the comments below on who you want to advance. I'm right here in the light of my vampire light. Was that as good for you as it was for me?
Seriously, it was terrible. That's terrible. All right, but I gave you the highlights, right? Save the footage. Content is precious. It's precious. Okay, so I don't know what you think. This is people's choice. So you got to vote down in the comments on which of these axes moves on. Okay, so I'm not trying to influence your vote. But, you know, and I know, there's clearly some intangible things about axes that you're not going to see in somebody chopping a vintage. Just like, hey, I want to know this and that. All right. So there's just two things I want to add before you vote on how the axes were at. So, I mean, the first is like, you know, I don't know what you call it. Fluidity of movement, pleasure to use, balance. You know, there's a lot of words we use for just the feel of an axe, right? And you just can't convey that in a video. All right. So my thoughts were as follows. Finnish collared axe, man, you can never go wrong with a hand carved handle. They're just fantastic. They always feel great. They always swing great. They're always balanced really well with the head. They're paired really well with the head by somebody who gives a damn. I mean, you're not going to carve handles for axes. Seriously, of all the things you're going to do, you know, you're going to be a handle carver unless you have really strong feelings about how an axe should swing and what you want to do with the piece. So this was great. And I think that stuff I put in about like the snow when my hands got wet and snowy, that was really interesting. That was really interesting because I found, you know, with this big Dr. Seuss knob here, that was very reassuring. That was really great. It helped my grip. And so with, like, for example, the Basque axe, which has this really, really slim, you know, that is a slim little handle there, and just a little bit of palm swell, right? So it can fit through the eye. It's just part of its design. That was tenuous. It was tenuous. Like, you know, it was like, woo, woo, you know, really probably need a new gloves, you know, just to be safe with that. But, you know, it's just one thing of many. And then the big German handles, you know, handles are a personal preference, but they make a big difference. And, you know, it's a style, and no doubt it's strong. But, you know, when it goes head to head, just for me, head to head with something slimmer, something more ergonomic, feels a lot better. Okay. So those are my thoughts on just the feel of the axe. All right. Take it as you will. Edge damage, edge wear. Okay. As the temperatures have gone down and I'm doing these groups, right? The minute the temps went down and the wood started to freeze and get harder, we had a lot more edge damage to all the axes, right? Great names, brand names, old ones, new ones. It really went up. All right. Duh. That's how it is. I think it's a great test just of the temper and the steel and that kind of thing, right? So how did the edges hold up from that aspen? You know, it's not a challenging wood, shouldn't be, even this firewood here. It should not be a big deal, right? But, you know, frozen, things happen. So the edge that fared the worst was the billnass, okay? There is small, completely acceptable, but perceptible roughness from heel to toe on this old Finnish axe, all right? So it's probably 100 years old. It easily could be 100 years old or more, right? So chop's great, nice little thin little bit, I loved it. But you can just feel a little roughness all up and down it. Just feel it with your thumb, okay? Now, you could sharpen that out with like just a 3,000 grit stone, you know, super fine, and just drive right on. So it's no chipping, you know, nothing broke in this. Next best edge was this Ochsenkopf steel, right? All right, Ochsenkopf steel on the Stihl, the steel on the Stihl, right? So even with that 22.5 grind I put on it, there's not a lot of damage, but there is. I can feel it. There's quite a bit of roughness up here at the toe, and then it goes back through there, and there's a couple of little rough spots, but did really well. No, did really well holding, keeping its sharpness. That's impressive, right? For you know, for the price of the axe, that's great steel. I think Ochsenkopf does a great job. Okay, and the best edge to hold up is this crazy Basque danger zone. Yeah, in the danger zone down there, very aggressive grind. It is not impervious to wear, as I can feel two little thummies. I can't really see them. You know what I'm talking about, right? You can feel them and not see them. All right, one of those. And then a little chip, just little chip. I can see the little gap there, okay? But you know, of the three, best wear on the chopping. So enjoy, guys. Vote, I don't know, give it a month. It takes me forever to do these videos. So vote in the comments below. We'll advance them to the next round with the elite axes. Elite axes, yes, right? I'm a vampire. Welcome to my home.